Okay, continuing further, let us now try to write the expression for the magnetic fields involved, the various magnetic field components involved. So if you take a look at the figure again, and you can, with the help of that figure, you can write incident, the magnetic field associated with the incident wave is given by AH cap, that's the direction of the field, the magnetic field, which as we know by now will be perpendicular to AE cap, because AE cap is the direction of the electric field. And as per the notation we have been following, okay, I can write beta 1 straight away because we have agreed upon the fact that the regions involved are dielectric. Now, with the help of the figure, you can write, if you take a look at the figure and apply your simple knowledge of vector algebra, you can write the tangential component of the incident magnetic field, tangential with reference to the interface. So T stands for the tangential. Tangential component of the incident magnetic field will be equal to, and if you look at the direction of the tangential component, it is in the negative AZ cap. So negative AZ cap. So probably I will write for tangential, okay, I can write like this. Again, if you take a look at the figure, you will know, because the angle between the tangential component and the magnetic field is theta I. The tangential component of that magnetic field and the magnetic field is theta I. And the rest of it follows. Now, you know that the role of wave impedance and the relation between the electric field, magnetic field and the wave impedance from the previous lectures. So if I make use of that relation, I can write the expression for the magnetic field associated with the incident field as given here, where this is the neta 1 is the wave impedance, it is the wave impedance in region 1. So once we have this expression, we can write similar expressions for the tangential component of the transmitted component of the magnetic field as well as the reflected component of the magnetic field. I will not explain that in this detail. I will just write the expressions straight away. We arrive at those expressions using exactly the same arguments as we used here. So having obtained the tangential component of the incident magnetic field, I can now write the tangential component of the reflected magnetic field as, again, if you take a look at the figure, you can see that the reflected magnetic field has its tangential component along the z direction and hence az cap here, and you have E naught r by neta 1, because again the reflected field is in region 1, cos theta I. Again, we know by this time that the incident and reflected fields will define the same angle theta I with respect to the normal, to the interface. And e raised to j omega t minus, or rather plus, it must be right for the reasons explained earlier, plus beta 1 cos theta I y. Again, if you see, I am not writing theta r here because we know theta r is the same as theta I. So this is for the reflected component of the tangential component of the reflected magnetic field. And finally, for the tangential component of the transmitted field, I can write the expression as, again, minus az. It must be obvious by now why it is minus az cap. E naught t by, note the difference here, it is neta 2 because this is the wave impedance in region 2 and transmitted field is in region 2. Cos theta t e raised to j omega t minus beta 2 because it's in region 2. Cos theta t y minus beta 2 sine theta t z. So here we have all the tangential components of the magnetic fields, and all that we need to proceed with our analysis is the tangential component. And we'll be using these tangential components to once again apply the boundary conditions and arrive at similar expressions as we arrived earlier. So now we apply the boundary conditions for the magnetic field, and in the absence of a current sheet at the interface, we know that the tangential components of the magnetic field have to be the same at either side of the interface. So like we did earlier for the electric field, setting y as equal to 0, because y0 is the interface. If we set y as equal to 0, the interface is on the xz plane. Setting y as equal to 0 and then equating the relations, that is equating the magnetic field, tangential component of magnetic field on the left-hand side, that is in region 1, just on the left-hand side of the interface, and on the right-hand side, region 2, just on the right-hand side of the interface, if we equate the magnetic fields, we will end up getting a relation as I show here. Again, I will not work out all the details here. So we are going to get expression like this if we apply the boundary conditions. Plus again, we know theta I is equal to theta r. Sine theta I z. So this is the left-hand side, that is in region 1, just on the left-hand side of the interface, equal to minus E naught t by neta 2 cos theta t e power minus j beta 2 sine theta tz. So now from the Snell's law, the Snell's law of refraction, which we had derived earlier using the electric fields, we apply that and arrive at a relation like this, because these terms can now be dropped because they will all be equal to each other. So I just drop them and we get a relation like this. We get a relation like this. So I will call this as equation 2. And we have equation 1, which we had derived earlier. I'll just write it down here for quick reference. So this was the equation 1, which we obtained earlier. This was the equation 1. Now, if we use these two equations, this is equation 1, which we got earlier. Now, if we use these two equations, using these two equations, and some a little bit of manipulation, which you can do on your own, we can arrive at relations like this. E naught t by E naught I, that is the magnitude of the transmitted electric field divided by the magnitude of the incident electric field, will be equal to 2 cos theta t neta 2 divided by neta 2 cos theta I plus neta 1 cos theta t. And we call this as the transmittance coefficient tau and put a subscript s to mean that this is for the s polarization. So this is the transmittance coefficient. I will not write it down. It is the transmittance coefficient because it gives the ratio between the transmitted electric field and the incident electric field. Similarly, you can show that E naught R by E naught I is equal to neta 2 cos theta I minus neta 1 cos theta t divided by neta 1 cos theta t plus neta 2 cos theta I, and we denote this as the reflectance coefficient capital gamma subscript s, again s to say that it is for s polarization. Now if you, having obtained these relations, if you put theta I is equal to theta r, which is obviously the case, is equal to theta t equal to 0, you will get the case of normal incidence. What we discussed till now was the case of an oblique incidence. So normal incidence actually becomes a special case of oblique incidence. You just have to put theta I equal theta r equal theta t 0, and you can see how these equations change. There will be, because all the cos terms will become 1 since the angles are becoming 0, and accordingly you can write your own expressions for the transmittance and reflectance coefficient for a case of normal incidence.